Now, are you sure you don't want to know anything about the parole board tomorrow?
No. I'm scared enough as it is.
Don't be. And above all, don't panic. And remember, I'll be waiting for you.
Thanks.
Best of luck.
Yeah.
Miss Phillip.
Oh, Pat O'Connell's son will be coming in with the work party that's coming tomorrow. To
Mrs. Travers, what the hell do you think you're doing? You know damn well you're not supposed to supply information like that.
Well, I thought Mrs. O'Connell already knew.
Miss Phillip.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher?
Kindly escort Mrs. Travers from the premises. And in future, just be a little bit more thoughtful. Not only have you made your own position very difficult, you've very likely created a great deal of trouble for Doreen.
How?
It's not her business to pass on information like that to other prisoners. And if we find out she has, it may well jeopardize her parole.
Oh, come on, it can't be that serious, surely.
Good day, Mrs. Travers.
I got a surprise for the kids.
What?
I've been doing this carpentry course.
Oh, you don't say.
Yeah, I made these really terrific toys. Oh, they're gonna love them.
Enjoying your little chat?
Davy! You look after yourself, love.
You too, Mum.
Nice to see you looking so happy. Must have been a nice surprise. Must have been like an early Christmas present.
Yes. Yes, it was.
I'm glad to hear it. You obviously thought it was worth losing your parole for. Of course, you won't be seeing your other children for Christmas now. You'll find Christmas a pretty quiet affair in prison.
What's up?
I caught O'Connell in the maternity wing, consorting with a male prisoner. They were caressing and talking through one of the east windows.
It was my son.
That's not relevant.
Well, under the circumstances...
Under the circumstances, Mr. Fletcher, it doesn't matter who it was. Come on, O'Connell.
Falkland has approved your request. Do you still wish to proceed?
Yes.
I can understand you're not wanting to have your child born in prison. It's certainly not the best place.
It's not that. I just don't want a baby, not here or anywhere.
This is a very important decision, Chrissie. It could affect your whole life.
I just don't want her baby. Doesn't anyone understand that?
Very well. I'll ask Dr. Miller to make the arrangements. And as you have such an aversion to babies, we'll take you off maternity ward duty immediately.
But Mrs. Davidson...
Yes?
Nothing.
Come in.
May I have a word with you, Mrs. Davidson?
Certainly. You may go. Dr. Miller will inform you of the arrangements when they're finalized. What is it, Vera?
I'm putting O'Connell on report for consorting.
Having trouble?
No, everything's fine. Why?
How long you been here?
I've just been in the kitchen loading bay.
Yeah, well, apparently O'Connell's son is on the working party. Vera caught them talking to each other through one of the windows of the maternity wing.
No. What's she done about it?
Hauled her up to the governor on a consorting charge. You can't consort with your own son, surely.
I don't know. Oh, but you know Vera.
Yeah, well, if she has her way, O'Connell can forget about having Christmas with the family.
Well, she's only doing her duty, of course.
Well, Withers is an old mate of mine. I'll find out what happened from his point of view.
They were caressing each other through the bars. They had every opportunity to exchange information and contraband.
What do you have to say?
He's my son.
Did you know this?
Does it make any difference?
O'Connell, I don't understand you. Up until now, your behaviour has been most satisfactory. You must have realised this would affect your parole.
I had to see him. I applied for permission when I was at Barnhurst, and it was refused. And Davy applied too, and he was refused. And then when I heard he was here in the garden, it was an opportunity I couldn't miss. Oh, what would you have done? He's my son, Mrs. Davidson.
How did you know he was in the work party? I see.
Please, Mrs. Davidson. I've got to get out by Christmas. I've promised my kids. My mother says she can't keep them after that. I've tried so hard to do everything right. My children need me.
You should have thought of that earlier, O'Connell.
How'd it go, Dor?
What?
Your parole board, of course, love. All right, I suppose.
Well, you don't sound too happy about it.
Give you a bit of a hard time, though, love.
Yeah, a bit.
But why? I mean, they're supposed to be there to help you, aren't they?
Oh, boy, have you got a lot to learn. That mob wouldn't help a little old lady cross the road.
You weren't too zonked out on that stuff the doc gave you, were you, love?
Nah, I was just pretending all that. Hey, did Pat get away all right?
Yeah. He should be gone a while, though.
Yeah.
Anyone seen Pat? I hope nothing's gone wrong. I wouldn't put it past that Latham bitch to dob her in.
Oh, she wouldn't, would she? Oh.
Speak of the devil.
And what are you doing here?
I'm on me break, same as you.
Did you see Pat's son?
What's he like?
I should I know.
Well, weren't you there?
No.
Well, why not? I told you to stay there and watch out for her.
I had to go to the governor's office.
She can't get anything right.
If you shopped Pat, your life's not going to be worth living.
I'll tell you, I was dragged off to Davo's office.
What for?
Something about the results of some tests the doc did.
Pat, what happened?
Did you see him?
Oh, what's the matter, love?
Come on, spit it out.
Vera caught me.
Bloody little lagger!
I warned you!
Stop it! Chrissie had nothing to do with it. She had to go. I heard Fletch talking to her.
And so Vera frog marched you off to the governor.
She tried to make out there's something between Davy and me.
Oh.
She's so twisted, I almost feel sorry for her.
Oh, someone ought to put her out of her misery.
What did Mrs. Davidson say? I guess she hasn't much choice. Looks like I won't get out for Christmas. And I don't know what'll happen to Emma and Andrew.
It's like banging a head against a brick wall. O'Connell has the record of a model prisoner. No one could have been surer of getting their parole, and then she goes and does something like this.
Yeah, it's a pity.
Pity? It's a foolish, utterly stupid thing to do.
Well, women are like that. About their kids, I mean.
And that's another thing. How did she know he was going to be in the work party? It couldn't have been just a coincidence. Have you any idea?
Well, yes, actually. Karen Travers told Doreen the last time she visited. She said it was a message from Angela Jeffries.
Well, why on earth didn't you report that? The whole thing could have been avoided.
Well, I didn't think it was important at the time. I told Doreen not to pass on the message. She seemed to understand.
Don't you realize the position you put her in? The women are intensely loyal. Doreen would have had to tell O'Connell.
Yeah, point taken. I've spoken to the officer in charge. Now, he's willing to forget the whole thing.
Oh, I'm sure he is. It was largely his fault.
Well, I was thinking, aren't we making a bit of a mountain out of a molehill? After all, a woman has spoken to a son. Now, that's hardly a crime.
In this case, the parole board would call it consorting.
Yeah, they would.
I don't want to ruin her chances of parole, but I can't let her get away with it.
Well, look, I was thinking, why don't we put her under extra work duties and suspend her privileges for a week or so?
Not report the incident, you mean? Well, that's rather an unusual suggestion coming from you.
Well, as you say, she has been a model prisoner. And if there's one thing I've learnt, it's how to temper discipline with a bit of good sense.
Very well. That's what we'll do. You'd better go and tell her. Save her a miserable night.
Right.
Come on, Doreen. 6:04. That's a double two. It has to be a 6:04.
Oh, you win.
What's the matter?
Nothing.
Is she up? You'll be getting out of here soon.
Oh, big chance.
Meaning?
Well, Fletch said if I passed that message on to Pat, I'd lose my parole.
Oh, he couldn't mean that. It's not a crime to tell someone something.
Tis in here. Fletch thinks he's real smart, doesn't he, Lizzie?
Yeah.
But he couldn't stop Doreen's parole just because of what she told Pat, could he?
A screw will try anything.
Whoever dubbed Pat in's got a lot to answer for, eh, B?
Yeah. That's right, Phil.
Well, I'm telling you, nobody dobbed me in.
It's all violence on the telly nowadays, isn't it? You know, I saw that war movie the other day. You know, the one where the hero shaved the heads of the girls who helped the enemy?
Oh, yeah, that was a good one.
We'd have to find someone who'd fraternise with screws.
Mm.
But who'd fraternise with screws?
We probably wouldn't know unless they were up the duff.
Smith, what's going on?
Oh, Chrissie saw something nasty on the telly.
You lay a finger on her, Smith, and you'll regret it.
Mr. Fletcher, I only happened to compliment her on her hair.
Latham,
true. I thought there was something in it.
O'Connell.
That's all there was to it, Mr. Fletcher, honestly.
The governor's decided that you're to lose all privileges for a period of 10 days.
Oh, miserable rot.
But so as not to jeopardise your parole, the incident won't be reported.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Report to me tomorrow for extra duties.
Yes. See, I told you it was a bit of all right.
Well, that sounds more like Davo to me.
You've done wonders with the place, Karen. It must have been pretty daunting at first sight.
It was a bit. There's still a lot of work to do on it, of course, but I think I'm over the worst. Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thank you.
There's something wrong.
Did you tell Doreen that Pat O'Connell's son was in the work party from Pentridge?
Yes, I did.
That was a very foolish thing to do.
Pat was desperate to see a son.
She was caught breaking bounds trying to see him. It nearly lost her her parole.
Just seemed cruel not to let her know.
Perhaps. But it would have been more cruel if she'd lost her parole because of it.
But Angela Jeffries...
Angela Jeffries hasn't been inside. You should have known better.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson. It won't happen again.
It had better not, for the sake of this place. As organiser, you will be privy to a lot of confidential information. We have to be able to trust you.
I understand. Will this jeopardise Doreen's chances of parole?
Doreen will be released tomorrow afternoon. I shall be very disappointed if she finds out before I tell her. As you know, we'll delay telling her as long as possible to avoid any trouble.
I won't tell a soul. What time is she being released? I want to go and pick her up.
2:30 p.m. Have you heard anything more from her mother?
No. I think she's lost interest.
Then it's just as well Doreen knows nothing about her. I'm very relieved she's going to be able to come here. She'll need a lot of patience and care. I'm sure you'll be able to give it to her.
I'll certainly try.
Good. Perhaps I will have that cup of tea.
Good morning.
The department gave me the go-ahead for Chrissie Latham yesterday. I had a talk to her, but she's just as determined as ever.
Well, I suppose I'd better start making the arrangements. Have they found out who the father is?
Not so far. But as long as it didn't happen here, that's the main thing. Fortunately for us, it's Barnhurst's problem.
Ah! Where are you going?
On the surgery. Don't come too close or I'll chuck all over you.
You're gonna touch the morning chunders, eh? Ah, the joys of motherhood.
Here. You still want to get rid of it?
Maybe.
I just thought I might be able to help you, that's all.
How?
Well, I could cut your bloody throat. That's how.
Oh, B, you promised.
Now, I just offered to help. I thought I could save her a lot of suffering.
Never you mind her, she's all bluff. Come on, I'll take you to the doctor.
Oh, dear.
What are you doing here anyway? You should be in the maternity wing in your condition. You've got to start looking after yourself now for the baby's sake. You've got to have lots of fresh food, fresh fruit and vegetables and milk.
Oh, God.
Is it true that O'Connell is not to be reported?
That is my decision, yes. I don't believe the incident should threaten her parole.
B. Smith couldn't wait to blurt out what she sees as my failure.
Well, I'm sorry you were subject to that, but I see no reason why the decision should be withheld.
She was caught red-handed. She must be charged. It totally undermines our authority if you let her off.
As I have explained before, I am the governor here, and I will run Wentworth my way. Once I have made a decision, I will not tolerate opposition.
But there are certain rules that must be obeyed.
Any officer who feels she is unable to accept the situation is quite free to tender her resignation. Is that quite clear? Doreen Anderson will be leaving us today. Would you see that everything is in order?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson. Mr. Fletcher, did you know she was letting that O'Connell woman off with an unofficial withdrawal of privileges?
Yes, I did.
Well, she's gone too far this time. It's ridiculous, don't you agree?
Well, no. As a matter of fact, it was my idea.
Your idea?
Mm.
I mean, what's the matter with everyone? Here's a serious breach of security, a shocking example to the rest of the women, and you're all pretending it didn't happen.
Oh, come on, Vera, wasn't that serious? Let's face it, in this job, you've got to have some compassion.
Thank you very much, Mr. Fletcher.
Come in.
Can I talk to you, Doc?
Yes, I was just about to send for you, actually. You're looking very subdued today.
Yeah, I'm not feeling the best.
Well, come and sit down. Well, Chrissie, all the arrangements have been made. You're to go and see the specialist the day after tomorrow, return here the same day, then spend a couple of days in the hospital for observation.
Yeah, well, that's what I wanted to see you about. Thanks for organising it, going to all that trouble and everything. But, you see, I don't want it.
Pardon?
The operation, I mean. I'm going to keep my baby.
You have done a lot to this place.
We're getting there.
I'd never have believed it would be so nice. I don't have much imagination, I'm afraid.
It's only had a good scrub. Look, Mrs. Hemmings, what are you doing here?
Have you heard anything about Doreen?
If you're that interested, you could put on another disguise and go and visit her again.
I know you don't approve of me, and I'm sorry, but please tell me about my daughter. I have to know.
I shouldn't tell you, but she's being paroled today.
Today?
Yes, at 2:30. I'm going to pick her up. Why don't you give us a lift?
No. No, I couldn't do that.
Then I can only repeat, what are you doing here? Doreen needs you, but only if you're going to care for her. Otherwise, stay out of her life.
Only I knew what to do.
It can't be that difficult to make up your mind. Either you want to know her or you don't. But it isn't fair to keep dropping in and out of her life whenever you feel like it.
Jeez, I could do with a cold beer.
Yeah, be nice, wouldn't it?
You know, I'll never taste a beer again. I'll never get out of here and I'll never taste it again.
Yeah.
Well, you'll be all right. You'll be out of here soon.
Oh, I don't reckon, Lizzie. I think they would have told me by now if my parole had come through.
Oh, you'll be all right.
Doreen, collect your things. You've been released in half an hour.
Oh, Doreen!
Well, get a move on. You want to stay here.
Told you, didn't I?
Fantastic, Dor.
That's just wonderful, love.
Karen will be coming to pick you up, won't she?
Told you'd be all right tonight.
Is it true, Mrs. Jackson? Oh, well, bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Lizzie.
Have a drink for me.
I promise.
I'll come and see you as soon as I'm out and we'll go on a picnic.
Yeah.
Don't you ever let me see you come back in here again.
Okay, B.
Bye, kid. Take care of yourself.
Yeah. Well, bye, everyone. Bye. 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 Hey, Dor! Dor! Hi, Karen.
Good luck, Doreen.
Yeah, thanks. Bye, Mrs. Jackson.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.
And Pat found out that Chrissie Latham is pregnant. We don't know how, but anyway, she's been transferred to the maternity wing now. Oh, and Bea found a way for Pat to see her son, only Vera caught her. We thought she was going to be put in the pound and lose her parole and everything, but Davo let her off. There's this new girl called Ros. Tony McNally shot her mum. She's real beaut. Ros, I mean. She's brainy, just like you. And they all send their love.
What else has been going?
Oh, nothing much.
Come on, I'm interested. Don't worry, you'll soon settle in. Why don't I make us both a cup of coffee? What do you think?
Oh, it's lovely. It's better than the prison. I wonder what they're all doing now.
Envying you, probably.
Oh, no. They're probably just saying good riddance.
Don't worry, you will settle in. Wait till you get used to wearing your own clothes, going out and doing things. It's a good feeling.
Yeah, me and Frankie, we did all that when we nicked off the last time. We saw things all right.
Yes, but this is different. This time there's no one chasing you, wanting to put you back inside. Don't worry.
Oh, I'm not. Will I have my own bedroom?
Well, you will have at the moment, with only the two of us here, but once the place fills up a bit, it'll be different. Then you'll have to share.
Oh, I like sharing. It's not the same as being by yourself. It's like being in the pound. Could I share with you until somebody else comes?
Well, I don't.
Oh, please,
so.
Karen. I'll be good, honest, I will. I won't be no trouble.
Wouldn't be the first time, would it? Okay, but only for a little while.
Yeah, thanks.
There's a spare key over on the wall there. Why don't you take it? I'll get some more cut tomorrow.
Oh, I won't need one.
Well, you might get locked up.
I'm not going anywhere.
Here. Take it. I'm not your keeper, Doreen. You're not inside anymore. You can come and go as you please. Outside, everyone has their own key. Maybe that's what makes the difference, the keys.
Yeah. But keys are trouble.
Not anymore. Look. Why don't we go out tonight, put on something nice and celebrate?
Oh, could we go out tomorrow night? There's this real good show on telly. I always watch it. It's Lizzie's favourite too. Could we watch it, please?
Yeah, sure.
This is rubbish.
Do you mind if I turn off?
Oh, no, I don't mind. I reckon it's pretty terrible myself. I was only watching because it used to be Dawes' favourite. Wonder what she's doing now.
Celebrating, probably.
Good old Dawe. I hope she's having a bonza time.
You must be eligible for parole soon too, Lizzie.
Yeah, suppose it will come through sooner or later. Don't know what I'll do with it, though. Oh, I know I go on about it, having a good time when I get out of here, and I suppose I would for a while, but then what would happen? Haven't got any family left to speak of, and I reckon all my old mates would be dead by now. You know, since I've been in here, so many things have changed. Sometimes when I read the papers, I don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, come off it, Lizzie. That's just because you need specs.
No, it's true.
Doreen was scared about getting out, too. She told me.
Oh, Dora, be all right. It's all right for you young ones.
Well, I don't know. Ros got a point.
Doreen's a beaut kid, but she's not the full quid.
Do you reckon she'll have a hard time?
Well, you know how much she needs looking after.
She's got Karen.
Karen can't be running after her all the time, especially when she's got others living there.
Oh. Maybe we should do something.
Don't know what we can do.
Well, there must be something. Maybe if I had a word with Doc Miller, he'd keep an eye on her.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
I was just wondering if you would... Oh!
Doreen was paroled today. She's staying here.
Hello, Dr. Miller.
Hello, Doreen. How are you?
I'm okay.
Actually, I just called around to see if Karen would like to come out for a drink. Look, why don't both of you come? Have a little celebration.
Oh, no, I've got to go to bed. I always do when the telly finishes.
Nonsense. You're not in Wentworth now, Doreen. You can go to bed whenever you like.
You go to bed if you want to, Doreen. Good night's sleep would probably do you the world of good. You don't mind if I go out, do you?
Are you going to be long?
I shouldn't think so.
All right. See you later then.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. I didn't realise she was getting out today. I thought you might be alone and be grateful for some company.
No, I'm glad you came. I understand Doreen's problem, but just sitting around here makes me feel like I'm back in prison. I'll go and get my coat.
You wanted to see me?
Yeah, sit down, would you?
I was due off duty 10 minutes ago.
Well, this won't take long. The maintenance work party are due to move around to the East Wing tomorrow. The women won't be able to exercise there.
One day inside won't hurt them.
Oh, perhaps not, but the children still need their fresh air and sunshine. They can exercise in the front garden with the other women.
How are we going to keep an eye on them all? There will be too many to watch.
Not if all the staff are on duty. Has O'Connell been put on to work detail?
Mr. Fletcher has rostered her on linen and food trolleys.
Good.
Which means that she has the run of the prison, practically.
Well, that shouldn't worry us. David O'Connell's been removed from the work party. Thank you for staying behind.
Thanks. Cheers. Here's to a better future for all of us.
I'll drink to that.
Well, and how does it feel to have your first customer?
I'm not so sure. I understand Doreen's problem, which is good in a way, but I don't know how I'm going to support her and yet teach her to be independent at the same time. It's not going to be easy.
Well, you may not have to worry about her for much longer. Not if her mother takes her home with her.
That's hardly likely. You know, Mrs. Hennings won't even admit to Doreen that she is her mother.
Well, why not?
Well, she doesn't want Doreen to get too involved in case things don't work out. If you ask me, it's the other way around. She's the one who's afraid of getting involved. Beats me why she keeps hanging about.
Well, she is her mother.
Then why doesn't she do something about it? Doreen's got enough problems as it is.
Oh, well, I'm sure something will work out.
No, I'm not.
Look, Karen, if you're going to succeed at what you're doing, you're going to have to learn to take a more detached view. You just can't afford to get emotionally involved with every ex-prisoner who comes in.
I know, but I can't help it. I know what it's like to face the outside world after spending time inside. Doreen's going to need all the help she can get.
Well, maybe she does, but just don't overdo it, eh?
All right, I'll try not to. It'll be nice when there are some women in the house, then at least they'll be able to help each other. Oh, by the way, Doreen told me that Chrissie Latham was pregnant, is that true?
Yes.
How did she manage that? She's been inside for ages.
I know. Pretty touchy subject with the department.
I bet. Poor baby. It's bad enough having spent time in there, let alone being born inside a prison. It's a label it'll have to carry right through its life.
Look, can we change the subject to something a bit more cheerful? I'm starting to get depressed.
I'm sorry, but I guess you'll just have to get used to it. I'm not free of Wentworth completely, you know.
Get used to it? Well, that sounds promising. Does that mean we'll be doing this again?
Unless you've got any objections.
None at all.
Come on, move yourselves.
Outside if you want your precious fresh air. I haven't got all day.
Hey, Vera, I hear we've got the Mothers Club exercising with us today.
I don't want any trouble out of you, Smith.
Oh, now, Vera, you got the wrong one. You should be looking for the bloke that got poor Chrissie up the duff. Here, got any idea who it was?
It's enough out of you, Smith. Now, get a move on.
You should let me have a chat to her. I bet I can make her talk.
Oh, now, lay off her a bit. You promised me you would.
Oh, geez, I don't know. You plucky mum, she spoiled all my fun.
Patsy, don't you?
Huh? What are you doing?
Well, Chrissie's not here.
Lucky for her.
You're not really going to get her, are you, B?
Nah. Not with 100 bloody screws around, anyway. I'm just stirring a bit.
Look at the pie.
Hello, Pat.
This is Rosie.
Hello.
And this is Rosie's little baby Sam.
Isn't he beautiful? Oh. How old is he?
11 and a half months.
Do you mind if I hold him?
Oh, he's all wet.
Oh, good, he usually is. I'll change you when we get back inside.
Have you got a spare nappy with you?
He'll be right in the sun.
Is Sam your first?
Yeah. Got him a month after I first got in here.
You married?
You're kidding.
I remember when mine were that age. Every day they seemed to do something new to surprise you.
Where are they now?
With their gran. Oh, I'm due for parole soon. I should be back with them by Christmas.
God, you must miss them. I couldn't bear not having Sam around. Must be rotten.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Doreen.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Look, there's some shopping to be done. Why don't you take a walk down the road?
Well, can't I help here? Or do a bit of gardening? I reckon that backyard could do with a real going over.
Okay, please yourself. Would you get the door? Doreen?
Oh, yeah, I'm going. Oh, hi.
Hello, Doreen. May I come in?
Yeah, okay.
Hello, Karen.
Mrs. Hemmings.
I just thought, as it's such a nice day, you and Doreen might like to come for a drive.
Oh, terrific. Can we go, Karen?
You don't have to ask my permission, Doreen.
Aren't you coming, Karen?
No, I'm busy, but you go along.
Yeah. Okay. I'll go and get my coat.
Why don't you come along, too?
Why?
Well, it'll make a pleasant change from this place.
I think you and Doreen should be by yourselves. Then perhaps you'll be able to tell her the truth.
Ready?
Good, we'll be off then. And we'll have some lunch out too. How does that sound?
Oh, great. Where are we going?
You can choose.
Bye, Karen.
Well, Doreen, where would you like to go?
Oh, I don't know.
What about friends? Is there anyone you'd like to see?
I haven't got any friends. Only in Wentworth. I wouldn't want to go there.
Isn't there someone you know outside of prison?
Only Karen. Oh, and Miss McBride. She was real nice to me and Frankie when we got out the last time.
Got out?
Yeah, me and Frankie escaped. Over the fence, went on the run. And Miss McBride, she was real nice to us.
Really?
Yeah, we was pretending we was nuns, you see, and Miss McBride invited us into her house and let us stay there. Anyway, it turned out she knew who we were all the time, but she didn't care, and I thought we were going to be all right until her stupid nephew came along. He tried to dob us in, but Frankie fixed him. We still had to shoot through, though.
Must have been awful.
Oh. Wasn't that bad, till the law caught up with us.
Where's
Frankie know?
Dead. Cop shot her. Bastard. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Hemmings. I didn't mean to swear.
It's all right, Doreen.
It's just that Frankie was the only real friend I ever had. She loved me. You know, really loved me. Not just like Karen or Wonky Warner.
Yes, well, look, if you'd really like to see Miss McBride, why don't we go there now?
Oh, great!
Place?
Perhaps she's having it done up.
Well, they don't look like workmen.
Is Miss McBride home?
Who?
Miss McBride. She lives here.
No, she doesn't live here anymore.
Oh.
Do you know where she's moved?
I think she's dead. We bought the place a couple of months ago. Deceased estate.
You didn't know her then?
No, we just bought the place.
She was a real nice old lady, but real lonely. So I suppose she wouldn't have mind croaking. Not if she was lonely.
Thank you.
It's okay, no problem.
I'm sorry, Doreen.
It's all right. Hey, can we go to the country now and see some sheep and cows and stuff?
All right.
Hello again.
Shh. Oh, sorry. Are you having a nap?
Yeah. A bit early, but he gets real sleepy after the sun.
Oh, it's best to put them down when they want to go. Babies always seem to know what's good for them.
Are you working in here now?
Oh, everywhere, really. I've got extra duty, which means pushing these trolleys all round the place. I don't mind, though. It was worth it.
Hey, Lizzie told me about you and your kid. Imagine them saying, talking to your own sons consorting.
Oh, they got rules, you know. Mrs. Davidson was real good about it. Mind you, I think Fletcher had a hand in it too.
Never heard anybody say anything good about him before.
Well, he doesn't show it much, but I reckon he's all right underneath. He could have given me a lot worse duties than this.
Are you doing the food trolleys too?
Son?
Oh, Sam's birthday next week. And I wanted to give him sort of a little party. What about getting some extra goodies from the kitchen, eh?
I don't see why not. So it's his birthday, is it?
Yeah, 1 year old.
Oh, it's a lovely age. They start getting to be real fun about then.
And we'll be leaving this place too.
Oh.
As soon as he's 1 year old, we'll both be leaving.
Well, that'll be great. We'll have to make sure it's a really good party.
Look, I wouldn't want to get you in trouble or nothing.
Oh, no, you won't. I'll tell the kitchen officer what it's for. She'll come good. They're not a bad lot, really.
Thanks, Pat.
Haven't had it easy, have you?
It was all right when I stayed with my auntie on the farm. We used to go with the dogs and chase the cows in from the paddock into the milking shed. That was good.
How old were you then?
Oh, about 11.
Pity you couldn't have stayed there.
Yeah. I might have been able to, but Dad hit a rich streak and he sent me to that posh boarding school. That didn't last long. We ran out of bread. I never saw my auntie again. Perhaps if I did, they might have let me keep the kid.
You had a child?
Yeah, but they reckoned I was too young to look after it, so they took it away. Got adopted. Sometimes I wonder what it's like now, you know.
Well, if you're interested, I know of an organisation that might help you trace the child.
No. Wouldn't want to know me now, would it? I'm no good to nobody.
If there'd only been someone there to help you, things might have been different.
No. B's right. I haven't got a brain in my head. I couldn't even make a proper living off the blokes.
You mean you...
Oh, I was never on the game proper. Just sometimes, you know, when I wanted something to eat or a bed. Some of the blokes were real nice to me, and that was fun. But I never made a quid.
Then you ended up in Wentworth?
Yeah. But I had a lot of friends in there. And somebody to look after me. It's not that bad inside.
Why don't we find a nice little cafe and go and have some lunch?
Oh, Mrs. Hemmings, could we go to a pub and have a counter lunch?
Well, I really don't
oh,
think...
Oh, please.
All right. If that's what you want.
Oh, terrific. Thanks, Mrs. Hemmings.
This food's appalling.
You'll get used to it.
I don't intend to be here that long. In fact, I can't imagine how long it'd take.
Ask Lizzie.
What's that for? Something to hide the taste.
Oh.
What's it like in the maternity wing?
Oh, nice. If it weren't for the bars, you could forget you're in prison.
Well, we won't be for much longer.
Speak for yourself. Be worse if you were stuck in here with a kid. Take Rosie. Her kid was born in here. She hasn't even been able to take it for a walk in the park or anything.
Oh, she'll be able to after next week.
How come?
You're getting out.
Like hell she is. She's got at least another 6 months to do. She won't be getting out.
She told me she was getting out with her kid.
Huh. Her kid might be getting out, but she won't. Bloody terrible, isn't it?
Did everything go smoothly this morning?
Yes.
Good. I'm afraid the old problem raises its ugly head again. Rosie Hudson's son Samuel is a year old next week.
Have welfare come up with the foster parents yet?
Yes, they'll be here on the day. These are the details. Does Rosie understand what's going to happen?
I think so. She's been here long enough.
Nevertheless, it's surprising how often they don't know. It's a subject the women don't like talking about. Therefore, the grapevine doesn't work with its usual efficiency. Well, I'll leave you to make the arrangements. Oh, and Vera, treat her gently. It's a terrible thing to have your child taken away from you.
Just what do you think I am, Mrs. Davidson? Some kind of monster?
Hi.
How'd it go?
Oh, terrific. We went to the country and I picked these. Have a sniff.
Nice.
We went to a pub and had a beer. I told Lizzie I'd have one for her. I can't remember the last time I had one.
I prefer tea any time. Are you making a pot?
You got a vase or something? I'd like to put these in our room.
Here you go.
Oh, thanks.
We went to see a friend of Doreen's, a Miss McBride. Do you know her?
No.
She hid Doreen when she escaped. She was apparently very old. She died a couple of months ago.
How did Doreen take it?
Very calmly. The young have that attitude toward death as if it could never happen to them.
Yes, Doreen's had a lot of practice at losing people.
Perhaps too much. That's why I mustn't get too close to her.
Well, why do you keep hanging around?
It won't be for much longer. I just want to make sure she's all right. You see, I've got terminal cancer.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.